Dum, 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 dum.
Does this look like a utility belt to you? It might just look like an old beat-up footstool to you, but that's not the way I see things, and I'm going to try to help you to see things in a different Batman light also.
Hey, Bat Buddies! Paul Roberts, Artsy One here. So the first thing we're going to do is take this nasty, brown, beautiful-looking leather off of this and use it for the materials we need for a nice, rustic comic belt look that already has all the great stuff, the gnarly qualities built right in of a lifelong bat utility belt. So here we go. So just for fun, let's keep it all free, right? Why not? So I get my latex in 55-gallon barrels, and they always come in pallet. I say, don't give me the pallet, I just gotta tear it up. Why don't you keep it? They don't want to take it off there. So I said, all right, give my kids something to do. Learn how to pull nails out, smash things apart. So we have wood from the pallet. I marked it. I'm gonna do it about the height of the buckle. There's four, and I can make more if I want to. They didn't get all the nails. I'll have to get after them later. So I'll just take the rest of the nails out here, and we'll have the base for making the pouches. We'll make the pouches. I'll have to have something underneath to wrap it around to give it some real weight and substance, but these pouches will take care of themselves. I'll show you all that part at least on the video, see what we do after that. I'm gonna use the most gnarly parts first. I could go on the sides, I got some pretty good leather there. But no, where the footrest is where Batman did the most damage to his belt, so that's what's gonna be the main material we use. By this time he's had so many successful missions, we highly respect whatever belt he might wear. I'm gonna cut this and use this main area. I'll probably use the sides for the bottom back base part that these go over. There should be enough to do each one of these. I'll draw some lines here. Don't have to draw if I've got a knife. Start out with a new blade. I love the oval. Up it goes, where it comes down, nobody knows. Don't do that by yourself. Using my straight edge from my college roommate who died in a car accident. I always like to remember him when I work. Very important. If you watch my How to Work in a Small Studio video that's on here, gives you ideas of what you can do to make your studio more meaningful to you while you work. Each one of these will make two. That's pretty good. I'm not gonna waste though, because I need to have a flap on the top. I'm gonna do this the same way that Clint Young did with the bat belts he did in the early 90s. Taken off an Adam West actual belt. I have one here, and I'm just gonna do it that way. I mean, even if I didn't have that to look at, I would say that's probably the best way to do it. They did what they needed to do to get the stuff up on the television screen each week. So what they did was, staples in the back. And if I really wanted to, I could make sure that I had the very best. But it's almost all uniform on the front, and I didn't check there, but I can see now that it is good. I'm just gonna fold this in a natural way so that when you look at it, you say, that's cool. I believe that a leather upholsterer put that together for you. I could do some cutting and make everything perfect, but if you see the top or the bottom of the belt, I think it'd be nice to see something that looks like that. When we're doing the folds, we'll go ahead and put the thicker staple in, go through the folds and into the wood. That's pretty cool. Gives a little rounded look at the bottom, or if you're actually looking at it, it looks like it's folded over. That's kind of cool. Same thing for the top. So there we have a very basic covering. I didn't do a lot of cutting. Now if I wanted to have these perfectly square, I could do more cutting. I might do them two different ways and see which one I like better. So the next one, I'll try different. I need another piece. I'd like to have one that's junky. This part here looks pretty junky. Oh, I like the stitch seam. I wonder if I should use that. Why not incorporate that, right? Maybe I'll use it for the belt though, because I see another stitch seam on this top one that I can use. That's cool. Maybe this Maybe the bottom has that. I was gonna do it where it came down like a V. Maybe the top has that. Maybe the back has that. Lots of options here. I like it. Let's see what we can do with that nice big thick seam there. Make it look like it's part of it. Why should we throw that out when we can use it? Trimming that up. Get it nice and flush with the seam. To make one top. There's plenty of this, so I'm gonna cut it just a little bit bigger. I use my fabric scissors for this. I could use a opal knife. Scissors work better for me for some things. I don't even do a lot of marks. I'm just gonna make it come out just a little bit more. Start my cut. Take it off. Just eyeball it. That looks about right. I'll go with that. If I leave that fold on top, I've got a slight curve to that. I don't know if I like that or not. So on the next one, I'll probably do it without that. And I'll probably do it two different ways. The ones that I like best will be in the front, and the ones I don't like will be in the back. Or if I really don't like the way it looks at all, I'll make it so that I do them all the same way. All right, so this is one flap. This could be left like that, but I'll probably go get a little button to put on there. After doing the first one, I decided the best way to do it. First off, cut a little more leather. I know I've got enough to work with to go all the way around. Not that anybody's ever gonna see the back, but you know, once you do one, you realize, well, what can you do to make the other ones a little bit better? So I'm still using the overlap on the bottom. I don't see any problem with having that. Looks like it's made that way. And anything that looks like it's made that way is a good thing. You've done your job, right? Because if Alfred sent it out, he'd make sure it was done by the best upholsterers. Don't let anybody know who they are or what they're doing, right? So you might as well do it that way too. So then I've decided that I'm gonna make the tops flat so it doesn't have a little bump in it when the flap comes down. Had a guy at Boys Club Art Room when I was a teenager. Put a staple through his finger for fun. Met all kinds back then. Well, I should mention in these videos, you need to know what you're doing. You can hurt yourself using power tools or anything really. I haven't really mentioned it, but I guess if I'm gonna keep doing this kind of thing, I gotta think of those things. There's a guy right next to me here in Calabasas, some big YouTube star. FBI raided his house the other day. He must be doing something a little bit more than making bat belts. Yeah. Keep your nose clean, keep your numbers down, live an okay life. Who needs that, right? You guys know who that is? That blonde-headed guy? Drives his motorcycle in the pool and different things. I don't know what he does. I don't follow those other YouTube people. I don't follow YouTube people that for the sake of being YouTube people, even though I'm a YouTube people. Because, gosh, come on. You gotta assume anybody that's listening to this right now, it's just because you like Batman and you might wanna, you know, do your own stuff or whatever, I don't know, or listen to somebody that has been into Batman their whole life just for the sake of listening. I guess that's possible. I don't know. But I don't question it. There's enough people now that I've got a better browser and I've got comments enabled and I can actually view them. I bought a computer from somebody that I can use. I don't want to upgrade my computer because my computer, if I upgrade it, I have to do all the software and all that stuff too. It would be really expensive. So I got another computer just to use for this. Just to use for the comments and stuff. You know, I went through the other day, I went through hundreds of comments that were from like a year ago. I had never seen them. So I apologize again. I tried to answer every single one of them to let you know that I wasn't trying to slight you if you happen to be one of the ones. And I think I'm all caught up now. So from this point on, I should do better. So we're finishing the last pouch here, and then I gotta decide what I'm gonna do with the belt. Now I'm not trying to make these things perfect, folks. I'm trying to give you inspiration so that you can do stuff like this. Take it on. See how easy it is to do. Be creative and make stuff happen. I could sit here and turn this video camera off and just work this to death until it's absolutely perfect. And maybe I will. No, probably not. Sometimes they do. But that's not the point. I don't know what is the point. I didn't think I could find this footstool because I went back and it wasn't there. So I went driving around. Sometimes I drive around in the morning with my wife, have some coffee. I was looking for other things that I might use instead. And I saw this leather chair, and I said, oh, I'm gonna grab that. And it was black, it wouldn't be as good as this. I brought it home, I looked at it, I said, why would I rip that apart? I can find something junkier. I ended up just fixing it, spent about an hour on it, fixed it. It's sitting in our house right now. Perfect, cleaned up. I'm not sure it's leather, but it looks like it's leather. But it looks good. It looks like a nice chair. And all that happened was somebody pushed down too hard on the arm or stood on it or whatever, and it cracked from underneath. So all I did was take the bottom off and look in there and push that back down. Get some reinforcement boards and glue it in place. Made sure that it was nice and flush with the other one. It's one of those old Memorex commercial chairs, you know, where he's sitting there like this. You listen to the Memorex. You know, is it live or is it Memorex? And his drink starts sliding across and he reaches over and grabs it. Have you seen that? It's like that. I thought, this just looks like a $400 leather chair now that I cleaned up and fixed it. So I didn't tear that apart. I went back on my jog today and I saw this and tear this apart instead. So there we have one. There we have four pouches. Obviously I've got buckles. And just to show you, this is a recreation of the Skywalker pouches in latex with foam on the back, painted. These are a little too small. I guess they could work for that. But I decided to make these just a little larger, but it was kind of inspired by this. I could just cast these like crazy, but not everybody casts, not everybody makes things like that. So I thought I'd show you something you can do to kind of simulate this with found objects and just in your garage, you know? You don't have to get into all this other stuff. I mean, I have things like this if you're interested, but why? There's no need, you know? Once this goes on the belt, it doesn't look any less good than that. Well, we still gotta put a little button on there. Why don't I do that now? So I always try to encourage you to do things differently every time and use different materials. Don't ever do things more than once. Unless you're like me and you do the same thing all the time, then you wanna get efficient at it, you wanna do the same things all the time and do them right and you do them well, that's okay. But if you're just doing something for yourself, try something new all the time. I would have liked to have used these for the buttons because they're about the right size, but I only got two. I've got these other little things I've stuck on there. I'm nailing them on. Really, I look at this now and I say, nope, I can't do it. I'm gonna do this to just one other one. And these will be the back ones. I'm gonna have mixed matched ones. I don't like that, but to me, the more important thing is that the front ones have the right size knob. I'm gonna pull this up a little bit so it looks like it's got a little play in it. Right where it needs to be, double check, give it a little tap. Perfect. That is the right size. I put it tight and then I loosen it just a little bit. So I really like that better. And I'm gonna put these on the back and one day when I get more, these are for underneath furniture. Hey, what am I thinking about? Of course I've got more of them. I just took apart a footstool. We got a time machine here. We can go anywhere. So let me replace these right now. I'm gonna take these off of here. And all of a sudden I've got six, not four. Hey, yeah. Thinking about what they actually were, furniture. What am I doing? I'm taking apart a piece of furniture. Of course I've got more. We got all the time we want. All right. Basically, I have one of every type of basic tool. And I would recommend, and you probably already do, because you probably do housework and things like that. I recommend just keeping them nearby where you are, because hey, I might be doing Batman stuff today, but I'll be doing house stuff tomorrow. Like I say, I fixed that leather chair this morning. Before I did this. There we go. I love it how whenever you're doing something, the first thing you think of is a movie. Even if it doesn't relate. I got a time machine, I got all the time I need. I've got a footstool, I got all the pieces I need. Yeah, that's what that is. Now, they're not exact, but they're way better, okay? There's the one off the footstool, there's the one that I had. Yeah, I like the one off the footstool better because it's gnarly. I could go ahead and take those off. I'm not going to do it for the video, though. I'm just going to get this thing done. Last thing. I took a piece of plastic. Didn't have a long enough piece, so I hot glued it in the middle. I cut it about a little bit less so that these could be more accentuated. They stick out just a little bit. That's up to you. Some people do it the exact same size. Then I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to take my more gnarly section. Actually, maybe I don't want to take my more gnarly section because you're going to not see it. It'll be underneath everything. Maybe I'll take my good section. Save my gnarly section for another time. I like that seam. I like that seam to be on the top. We have to use too much of it to make that happen. I wanna have the seam. I don't care if I only see it on the top. I think it'll add something to it. It'll look like it's upholstered rather than a craftsman putting it together, right? There's the seam. It has to wrap around. Seam has to be shown on the top. That much will wrap around. So that's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna make this so the whole belt is leather. Why not? I won't have as many scraps left over, but hey, the whole purpose was to make a belt out of this footstool. I've got plenty of other leather, and I can get leather anytime I want. Got people sleeping on the streets around here. And they got all kinds of great old junky stuff that they just throw out. They come around, clean it up. Every once in a while, they make a new mess. Sometimes I get to the piece before they get it. It's a little bit less gnarly. So I get more leather. I'm gonna make this belt right. There's the seam. I'm gonna put this underneath it. I'm gonna wrap this around it. I'm gonna have the seam on top. I'm gonna have this fold around back. There's the seam. I'm gonna have it mostly towards the top. A couple little adjustments here. Make sure that's down right. I'm gonna fold this around this. I'm gonna look at this. Actually, I'll go all the way across. See if that does it right. Just double check it. Pretty close. I still remember the first day I ever used a glue gun. 1983 in college, freshman year. Pretty fun. We had to make cardboard biomorphic abstractions. Fun stuff. Stupid stuff. If you kept doing it the rest of your life, I'd be ARTSY1. But I didn't. I took what I needed to learn and applied it. And I try to be artsy with two E's. And just wrap that on over there like that. And this is no upholsterer's approach, but it'll work for cosplay. It'll work. You could do this whole belt, and I'd say under an hour and a half. I mean, I'm fooling with video and stuff like that, but we're talking about find a footstool, tear it apart, get your stuff out in your garage, cut a few pieces, you're done in an hour and a half. For today's purposes, I'm gonna roughly glue these down just to finish up, to show you what you could do. Just for now. Not final, not perfect. Just to simulate what you can do. Tack it down, see if you like it. Come back later if you like it. Finalize it. And you know what, just for today, just for the purpose of the video, I'll go ahead and put this on here. I'm gonna take it off, I know I am. I'm gonna give just a little bit of gold sheen to those little buttons. I like to not really actually paint them. I like to just kind of like suggest that that's there. If you go in and making sure everything's perfect, then the sides and everything and how it hits the leather all comes into play, and before you know it, you got just noodling yourself to death. There's no need to do that. So I've got these lightly attached. I want to check it out with my costume, make sure I like everything, the way it looks when it wraps around me. But here we have, in probably an hour or less maybe, I was fooling around with the video and stuff like that, but you can put together a real leather utility belt. And it's just lightly attached, like I said, the buckle I'll be using for something else. I'll probably put a different buckle on there. You can have this real easily just by applying yourself. And I think it'll mean more, you know? Maybe you get out of the house when it's crazy. Take a little time in the garage, have a little peace. And then you come back in and you go, honey, I'm not gonna have to spend $250 like I thought. After all, I made my own real leather utility belt. And she'll go, that's wonderful, honey. I'm gonna make you the nicest dinner. No, we're gonna go out of the town. Well, you see, everybody has it a different way. But basically, you're doing things. You're having fun. You're making a great costume. And the real fun's gonna come when you go out and use it. People go, wow, where'd you get that? I made it. At least part of it, you can say, well, parts of it I made. You got this all this whole great suit, and you go, well, certain parts I made, like this belt, for instance. Real leather. I put it together in my leather shop back at my studio. You don't tell them it's out of an old footstool. All right, so there you go, guys. Another real quick, show you can do it project on the table today. I'm Paul Roberts, Artsy1. Talk to you later, Bat Buddies.